je pense que j'ai eu une enfance avec beaucoup d'amour. Mes parents, ils m'ont donné tout l'amour que j'avais besoin. En tout cas, je sais que j'ai eu une enfance épanouie, heureuse au niveau de l'amour de mes parents et de ma famille. Donc voilà, après mes soucis sont venus un peu plus tard. Mes parents, ils ont quitté l'Algérie très 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 jeune pour faire leur vie professionnelle, pour faire des enfants. Ils vivent en France actuellement. Pour chaque immigré, venir en France ou dans un autre pays, c'est forcément difficile. Donc oui, ils ont une vie très 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 dure, jusqu'à présent encore. Donc on fait en sorte que leur vie se passe le mieux et qu'il y ait le plus de joie et de bonheur dans leur cœur et dans leur tête. C'est ça mon but. Vu qu'on est une très 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 grande famille, bah, moi je suis au milieu, j'ai un petit frère, une petite sœur, un grand frère, une grande sœur. Et moi, donc on est cinq. L'histoire qui a défini ma vie, c'est quand ma mère elle est tombée malade d'un cancer des poumons. Donc vraiment très très avancé. Le pronostic vital de ma mère était très 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 engagé. Et j'étais jeune, moi. J'avais 19 ans, 18 ans. J'avais mon petit frère et ma petite sœur qui étaient très très jeunes aussi. Donc c'était une très 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 grosse épreuve. J'ai dû m'occuper de mes frères et sœurs, m'occuper de la maison, des allers-retours à l'hôpital. Cette tragédie-là m'a vraiment affecté. C'est très dur étant plus jeune. Bah, heureusement que j'avais une famille qui tenait la route. Donc j'avais des tantes, des oncles qui étaient là pour nous, un père qui était là pour nous. Il fallait que j'accélère ma vie professionnelle très très vite, que je trouve un moyen vite de faire de l'argent pour subvenir aux besoins de ma famille, de mes petits frères et sœurs, de ma mère, de mon père. Donc je me suis mis tout de suite dans la boxe. Je faisais déjà des combats et ça m'a poussé vers l'avant à vouloir être champion le plus vite possible, à pouvoir gagner ma vie avec la boxe le plus vite possible, vu qu'il n'y avait que ça que je savais faire. Voilà, fallait que je me focalise sur la boxe, sur ma carrière, fallait gravir les échelons pour être où j'en suis maintenant. Donc je suis très fier de ça.
This one Super Series kickboxing rule set. You are allowed to clinch under these rules, folks, for as much as 3 seconds, as long as the knees and the clinch are continual. France versus Italy. Armin Petrosyan with the great Giorgio Petrosyan in his corner. And Samy Sana, the height and reach advantage go to Sana. He's got the project armbands around his biceps here. The towering Frenchman. Huge experience as well goes the way of Samy Sana. 132 wins. Petrosyan has 69 wins. Both men just testing the waters early here. Those 4 ounce clubs are being employed tonight. Both men carrying very high guards, and rightly so. Petrosyan tries to cut the angle, then goes downstairs with an outside thigh kick.
Sana's got a massive reach advantage of 10 centimeters. You gotta wonder how he's gonna use it, utilizing that nice big jab. Petrosyan throwing that overhand right as he catches the kick there.
Petrosyan looking for his first win in one Super Series. So too Samy Sana of France. Sana lost to Sorgro by decision last time out. Of course, Giorgio Petrosyan just beat Sorgro by decision. Right hand there, counter right hand from Samy Sana, drifts back to center cage. On the front foot, the Frenchman. Overhand right from Petrosyan, they tango. Samy lands a short right hand. Petrosyan trying to crack through the guard with a right hand of his own.
He's throwing a big overhand right, trying to reach that chin of Sana.
Two punch combination for Petrosyan, looping off both hands. Overhand right from Petrosyan, that one had a lot of starch behind it. Samy Sana looks for the switch kick, didn't fire it, takes an inside leg kick. Left hand followed by a looping right there from Petrosyan, but nothing connecting. Overhand right from Petrosyan. Body kick from Samy Sana. Throws it again to the waist of Petrosyan. Now they're picking up the speed here in the opening round. It's only 3x3 in one super series. You've got to work hard and fast early. Oh, tagging right hand from Samy Sana. Got the momentary wobbles there, did Petrosyan. That right hand landed clean on the jaw. Samy Sana probing with the left, Petrosyan falling forward. No knockdown, of course, says referee Onari. Maybe still recovering from that right hand, Petrosyan. He trips into the right hand, dangerously so. He's going to go the other way. He gets tagged again. He drifted straight into the right hand of Samy Sana.
He's trying to go away. Sana threw the kick, caught him with the body kick, and then before the foot even touched the ground, Sana was throwing that right hand and connected right on the chin of Petrosyan.
Petrosian's in trouble here. 30 seconds remaining in the first. A dump there from Samy Sana. And a caution from referee Onari. Can you find that right hand again? Petrosyan's got to drift to his right. Into the left side of Sana, not into the right side of Sana. The right side's where the danger is.
Now look how Sana's cutting off that angle. He's using those big, long legs to cut the corner so that Petrosyan has to go to the right. He has to go to his left, and that can't go to the right.
Sana said he wanted to beat Armin Petrosyan tonight, and then he wanted to face Giorgio Petrosyan in 2019. First round down, we go to the towers. It's going to be a 10-8 round. Unofficially on my scorecard, a 10-8 round for Samy Sana.
Here's that work by Samy Sana. Caught the kick and boom, connected right on the button with that big right hand. Here's the second one. Look at that. Lifts up the right hand, fakes the right hand before he throws that leg again. That leg is on the way down. He's throwing that right hand, lands a hammer of a right hand.
Vote for the bounce of the night on the One Super App. You can win an all-expenses-paid trip to One Championship event. Download it now. It's all fights, all live, all free. Cut under the left eye of Armin Petrosyan. And Samy Sana, the Frenchman, on fire and looking fresh.
Yeah, he's looking good. He seems to have Petrosyan figured out, at least in the first 2 minutes of that round. He's closing that distance well, cutting off the angle, making sure he drifts into his power side, and then he's landing that big right hand.
Second round of three inside the magnificent Mall of Asia Arena in Manila, the Philippines. It's a One Super Series kickboxing contest. France versus Italy. Samy Sana with the momentum in control, and he opens up strongly again. The straight line punches. There's the left hook from Armin Petrosyan. Go! Petrosyan's got to drift the right way, got to keep the gloves up here. Good counter right hand there from the Italian, from Milan.
How he evaded that right hand of Sana. He's got to do more of that.
Jab two from Petrosyan. Sana trying to stay planted in center cage here. These 4 ounce gloves make such a difference when it comes to the connection power. Thought about the left roundhouse kick, did Sana. Thought about it again. Finally goes to the inside lead leg. Didn't turn the knuckles into that right hand, Petrosyan. High kick from Sana, going for the headache maker. Petrosyan, left hook, leans back. Some better signs here from Armin Petrosyan. Jab two, full extension from the Italian. Beautiful left hand there from Petrosyan. Now gets backed up by Sana. Sana tries for a knee. And referee Onari breaks them.
See, Sana instinctually tries to go for that clinch once he closes that distance. And then he remembers and he has to try to separate.
Sana edging forward. Oh, nice stiff hand there from Petrosyan. Throws the overhand right.
Petrosyan's trying to make up that reach factor by throwing that overhand right. In this round, it's starting to land.
This is a scintillating second round of One Super Series kickboxing action. Samy Sana doubles up the outside leg kick to the lead thigh. Just to that common peroneal nerve above the lead knee of Armin Petrosyan. Again, Petrosyan just losing his footing there. No knockdown, of course. Go! Sana on the front foot. Thought about a roundhouse kick. Overhand right from Petrosyan, catches the forearms. Sana, a nice high knee to the sternum there from the Frenchman. Gotta make sure that he curls the fist there, Samy Sana, and doesn't throw with the fingers extended. Step through knee from the Frenchman. And referee Onari breaks some 45 seconds on the clock here in the second round, Dragon.
Better round for Petrosyan. He's starting to find his mark. He's starting to close that distance, and he's getting inside the reach of Sana.
Sana looking for the right hand. The step through knee was nicely done. You can see the reddened left side of the body of Armin Petrosyan. Leans back effectively there to Sana. Overhand right from the Italian. Can't find the way through the forearms guard. Back against the wire here, Petrosyan needs to get off there. He's a sitting target. High knee from Sana. Petrosyan's got to get off the fence, and he does now.
Sana does a good job of catching that kick, then just disrupting the balance just a little bit of Petrosyan by throwing it up in the air and then coming over with a punch.
We go into the third round. Some better signs there from Armin Petrosyan as Mehdi Zatut lifts up his charge, Samy Sana.
First round looked really sharp for Sana, but Petrosyan starts to surge back in some of the exchanges. Sana, this is where they had an initial tanglement. Petrosyan started to turn away, but that's just because the pressure from Sana is so intense. Michael Civello, unofficially, of course, how do you have it scored so far?
10-8 opening round, unofficially. I'll go the way of Samy Sana. Second round, better signs from Armin Petrosyan, but I'll still edge it the way of Samy Sana, 10-9.
Interesting. I wasn't expecting that. Okay, Michael Civello.
I thought Petrosyan was a lot more active in the second round, Mitch, but he didn't land as much as he tried to throw, and Samy Sana was a little more precise. May not have had the volume of Petrosyan, but landed more than Petrosyan from what I saw.
Okay.
Third and final round.
Again, Michael Civello is not an official judge. He just pretends to be one on TV.
The Mall of Asia Arena. I look around this magnificent stadium and we're at about 97% now. Leg check from Petrosyan to start the third and final. Oh, he tagged him on the jaw with that one. Is this the moment for Petrosyan? Is it the opening he needs? Can he follow through here, the Italian? He momentarily stunned Samy Sana with that right hand.
See the knees just sort of buckle ever so slightly of Samy Sana.
Dead center of the cage. Jab, right hand. The old 1-2 there from Petrosyan. Cheap kick to the lead leg. Fakes the right cross.
Nice evasion by Sana. He's able to see those punches coming. He countered with a knee.
Looping left hook there from Petrosyan. Then dances out of the way of trouble. The old 3-2. That's his brother's favorite combination. The old 3-2. The hook to the cross.
Throws it out of the orthodox stance, so it's a bit different coming. It doesn't come with quite the same velocity that Giorgio throws it with, but it's still very effective.
What an amazing story, the Petrosyan brothers in the martial arts world. They grew up in the most abject poverty, escaped war-torn Armenia, were living at a train stations and in the gutters on the streets in Milan, Italy, with their dad. Eventually turned their lives around and found the martial arts, and they both sit atop the martial arts world, especially Giorgio Petrosyan, the greatest kickboxer of all time, in the corner of his brother Armin Petrosyan tonight, who's got 90 seconds remaining. Left hook there from Petrosyan, right hand lead. Samy Sana has slowed down. That right hand came agonizingly close. Just needed a bit more extension. Jab two from Sana. There's a knee at short range from the Frenchman. Has somebody got what it takes to go kleptomaniac and steal it in the last minute?
Sana, it looks very impressive when he's the one moving forward, when he's the one engaging. And that's what this is. It's just about keeping the other foot, the other opponent, on your back foot. If you're dominating, if you're moving forward, you're winning the match.
45 seconds now. Petrosyan just popped him on the nose as Sana tried to step through with the knee. Spinning back fist there from Petrosyan. Counter right hand from Sana with a flying knee. Nicely done from the Frenchman. Referee Onari breaks them. Got to commit here. Petrosyan does so with the right hand. Sana got to the outside of it. Good evasion from the Frenchman. Little mouse under the left eye of Petrosyan. Hasn't been a lot of clean strikes landed here from Sana. Final seconds now. Sana offering his chin. Trying to sucker Petrosyan in. Fires a right hand as a lead punch. Elbows allowed in this one. Final seconds indeed. We are going down to the judges here in Manila. wherever you're watching, folks, live on Facebook, live on Twitter, live on the One Super app, how do you score it? Do you have it for Samy Sana? Do you have it for Armin Petrosyan?
Very close round there. Samy Sana looked really good. He was the one pushing forward. Let's take a look at this big right hand from Petrosyan. Look at that. Parried the hands down and came right over the top with that right hand. Samy Sana answers back with one of his own. There's that right hand that was missing just a little bit of extension. Samy Sana says, nope, my turn now. Lands a hook and continues to push forward. Very entertaining One Super Series matchup. Kickboxing rules with small gloves, Michael Schiavello.
Doesn't get any better than that. Do the faces tell a story? I believe they do. Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Samy Sana.
Samy Sana gets his first win in One Super Series, a unanimous decision over Armin Petrosyan. The winner's medal goes back to Paris, France. That's not to be for the Italian.
Ready, go!
We're about to find out. Michael Schiavello, Mitch the Dragon Chilson, Smoke and Joe Nutterwhat in the green, Giorgio Petrosyan in the black. Right hand down the tube early from Smoke and Joe. He's got to fire the right hand. Public enemy number one of the southpaw, who is Giorgio Petrosyan. High kick from Nutterwhat. Petrosyan aggressive early with that beautiful, that stupendous right hook of his. Nutterwhat may have the edge in power, Petrosyan in speed and in precision. Roundhouse kick, but Petrosyan catches it on the forearms. Cross lead there from Petrosyan. There's the hook, followed by another cross down the center. Step through knee from the Italian. Good outside thigh kick from Smoke and Joe Nutterwhat. Counter left hand down the tube off the roundhouse kick. Joe goes for the headache maker. Beautiful knee on the inside from Nutterwhat. This one has started at a tremendous pace, Mitch.
That Ferrari's got some heat to it. He's throwing some serious shots with a lot of horsepower behind him. This is not the typical Petrosyan we're seeing. We're not seeing that footwork, that left-to-right movement. He's throwing bombs, Michael.
This is an impressive incarnation of Giorgio Petrosyan. You can see that Joe Nutterwhat, the plan is to go shin around neck. Counter shots again from Petrosyan. Thought about the knee, and immediately Nutterwhat negates that and charges him to center in. Petrosyan roundhouse kick to the body lands. Let's see if Nutterwhat maybe tries to take out Petrosyan's legs. It's one way to slow down the boxing, take out the legs. Every punch begins from the feet and rises up the body. If you can take out the legs, take out the hands.
The eyes of Petrosyan are so sharp. Just the way he slid just an inch, just like a centimeter away from that high roundhouse kick from Nutterwhat.
Again, he just leans back, inches only. Beautiful left cross down the tube. Nutterwhat throws the right hand. Overhand right from Smoke and Joe. Jab two, step through knee from Petrosyan. Joe's got to get off the ropes here. Front kick from Petrosyan. And Joe does that, trips to his left, back to center ring. Good inside leg kick, maybe a little high. Just connects to the groin of Petrosyan. And referee Ulinari will allocate some recovery time here in front of a sellout crowd in Manila and 136 countries watching live. An accidental kick to the groin there from Nutterwat.
Nutterwat's having a hard time getting off. He's kind of letting the pressure of Petrosyan overwhelm him, and he's not able to really get started into this match.
I think that Nutterwat needs to start letting his hands go a little more than letting those kicks go. He's got some monstrous hands if he opens up here, Smoke and Joe.
Petrosyan's putting such pressure on him, forward pressure, and he's just sliding out of the way of that head kick so precisely, but then coming right back with shots of his own.
The timing of Petrosyan. He shouldn't be Italian, he should be Swiss with timing like that.
Final 10 seconds. There's a right hand down the tube from Smoking Joe Nutterlock. There's a high kick. Petrosyan with the hook and the body kick. Catches the roundhouse into the first round. Two more rounds remaining. It's the main event of the One Super Series tonight. Live from Manila in the Philippines in front of a massive sellout crowd.
Take a look at some of this action. There's Petrosyan, catches the counter, comes right back with two big right hooks. As Nadawat comes forward, but just barely misses a high roundhouse there as Petrosyan whiffs a big right hook. Takes one on the body, answers right back with shots of his own, but that's been the story of this round. It's that forward pressure and the punching of Petrosyan, putting together the combinations, going from the hands to the feet exceptionally well.
Kumpondechgumbu in the corner of Smoking Joe Nutterwhat, who emerges first from his corner. What strategy have they given to the Thai? Look at this crowd. They've turned out thousands upon thousands for this. And also that main event to come, Kevin Bellignon, Andrew Leone, second round, set for three. Smoking Joe versus the Doctor, the monster truck versus the Ferrari. Mikey, you see the timing, the counter there from Petrosyan, just exquisite. So precise, so fast. Step through knee and the hooks from Petrosyan, backing up another one. Very few opponents back up Smoking Joe Nutterlock.
Petrosyan's doing it. Look at the way he's putting those punches together. Goes from the hooks to the straight left hand. Just overwhelming Nutterlock. Nutterlock can't seem to find the answer for this pressure.
Petrosyan's beautiful lead hook again. The prime technique of the Italian. Nutterlock needs to probe with the jab. Got to start kicking the legs of Petrosyan. Throws a two-punch combination to the tie. There's the head kick. It came agonizing and close to shaving the beard. Petrosyan goes downstairs to the back leg. Right hand over the top there from Nutterwhat. Checks the thigh kick. There's one to the hamstring of Petrosyan. Little step across angle and a roundhouse kick from Petrosyan. Catches the kicking leg. Step through knee from the Italian. Oh, and Petrosyan gets stuck to the canvas.
Beautiful.
Smoking Joe with the crunched armbands around the biceps here, representing Muay Thai. Uppercut from Petrosyan. Throws the knee on the inside. Referee Onari breaks them. 1 minute 20 remaining. Time for Smoking Joe to pick up the pace now. There's a nice right hand. There's a head kick from Smoking Joe. Luckily, Petrosyan had the left arm up. Side kick. Petrosyan edges forward. Watch for the hook on Petrosyan. There it is, top of the head. Step through knee, belly button through the back. Good hands from Petrosyan. Petrosyan resetting, dead center of the ring. Nutterwhat catches the kick. Good return kick of his own and a high check from Joe Nutterwhat. Petrosyan counter right hand, left hook, outside thigh kick.
30 seconds left in the second round.
Body shot, step through knee from Petrosyan. Onari breaks them. Plenty of instructions coming from Petrosyan's brother in his corner. Roundhouse kick from Smoking Joe. But the way Petrosyan threats the hand combinations is sublime. Checks the inside thigh kick to Smoking Joe. Two rounds down, one remaining.
Better round from Smoking Joe, but he's still allowing Petrosyan to push forward and back him into either a corner or up against the ropes. And then Petrosyan's able to unload on him. He does answer back quite well in a lot of these exchanges. Right there, landing that big right hook, but he's moving around. But Petrosyan is just consistently pressing forward and controlling the distance and the spacing of Smoking Joe. Smoking Joe's used to being the aggressor. He's used to moving forward. But Petrosyan has changed up his tactics. He's now the aggressor. That Ferrari is trying to run over the monster truck, Michael.
Both very calm in their corners. What strategy will they come out with in the third and final round? It's the ONE Super Series, and what a way to launch! A three-time world Muay Thai champion, Smokin' Joe Nutterwhat, and simply the greatest, Giorgio Petrosyan.
Michael, you've been watching Petrosyan for as long as he's been in the ring. What do you think of this new style that he's adapted?
It's a more aggressive style from Petrosyan. It relies on power a lot more than he did in the past. I like it from Petrosyan. Still got the speed, still got the timing and the reflexes. But now it's time for Nutterwhat to stamp his authority, to lay down his power salvo. To not allow himself to get backed into a corner or pressed against the ropes by Petrosyan. Start for Joe to pull out the stops and throw caution to the wind here. Good counter from Joe, good counter from Petrosyan. Hook and a body shot doubles up the lead hand as Giorgio Petrosyan just gets out of the way. That roundhouse kick and the low kick. Body shot from Petrosyan, a clinch up. Petrosyan throws a knee and he reaches Joe to the canvas.
Beautiful timing. He waited to lift up his leg. And as soon as he lifted up his leg, he redirected his head and put him on his butt.
Uppercut to a hook there from Petrosyan. Another one on the front foot. Catches the kicking leg, does Petrosyan. It's time for Nutterwhat to let the hands go here.
He's constantly off-balancing Nutterwhat. As soon as Nutterwhat puts pressure on one leg, he's attacking the leg. He's constantly redirecting and controlling the balance of Nutterwhat.
Nutterwhat throws out the right hand, but Petrosyan sees it coming. The Italian operates in millimeters. Beautiful dipping body shot off the right hand from Petrosyan. This time Nutterwhat gets out of the way of the high roundhouse kick. Jab from the Italian. Beautiful cross down the corridor from Petrosyan. Nutterwhat tries to thread the high kick. 1:10 remaining now. Petrosyan with the aggression on the front foot. Nutterwhat with the hook. Need to employ the right hand here. Put his lead foot on the outside of Petrosyan's lead foot and throw that long reaching right cross. Petrosyan goes high. Step through knee from the Italian. Two punch combination, Petrosyan. Time is running out here for Smokin' Joe Mitch.
He's got to put the pressure on. He's got to start attacking. He's got to quit backing up and start moving forward. Not allowing Petrosyan to get him cornered into that box right there.
Can't imagine what it would be like to face Petrosyan in the ring. Joe Nutterwhat is realizing what it's like to compete against a man he has idolized for years. Against the greatest. Front kick from Petrosyan. Nice hard check there from Smokin' Joe.
Nutterwhat's doing a good job. He's just slightly being out-edged in every exchange. In every almost every point, Petrosyan has the answer for what Nutterwhat's doing. That
tremendous
is true. The greatest kickboxer of this generation.
You saw Petrosyan again at the height of his mastery. And a fantastic effort from Smokin' Joe Nutterwhat. He had his moments over those three rounds. But when you face Giorgio Petrosyan, when you face the master, this is what you get. Accuracy, timing, speed, power, precision, mixed with aggression. Giorgio Petrosyan using all his tools and using them superbly.
Very impressive. So what's your impression of the ONE Super Series?
A smashing success tonight, the ONE Super Series. Four tremendous bouts, each gave us something different. And in this main one of the ONE Super Series, it was true artistry. A real Donatello, a Da Vinci, a Raphael, call it what you like. Giorgio Petrosyan painting another masterpiece in the ring. Let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Giorgio Petrosyan!
Giorgio Petrosyan! change his winning ways. Keeps his streak alive. The spoils go back to Italy with the doctor. A martial artist